I think everyone likes snacking on chips, especially when it's too hot. You don't want to cook, you don't want to bake, and you want to be full and happy. What you make it with is simple bread, Armenian bread, lavash, flat bread. Especially the one that you think it's kind of not too fresh and you don't want to waste it. What you do, you cut it first of all into, let's say, bite size, chips size pieces. You do that first and I'll let you know the rest in a little bit. How do you like it spiced? It really depends on your taste preference. Of course, some olive oil won't bother. I have extra virgin olive oil. I like it with sumac, which makes it slightly tangy. It's a really good taste. And of course, black pepper will be present. Garlic, where is garlic powder? Is a good addition. If you like it onion taste, add onion powder as well. Jalapeño or cayenne red pepper should be good. What else? I think that's it. Oh, what else? Some dry herbs. If you like oregano or dill, thyme, any of your preferred herbs. Since my children are picky eaters, I don't want to risk it. I'll skip the herbs. Okay, oven 375 degrees.
And the helper.
And the helper is here. Since this morning, he woke up and he wants to make a video for his Lego channel.
It's a helicopter.
Okay, it's a helicopter, by the way.
With money.
Of course, with money. He's a guy who likes counting money. You have only one money? Oh, that's the money? How much?
$100.
Oh, $100, wow. Okay. Okay, you need to wait, Anka. Mom needs to finish her video first. Because we have only one camera guy and we're trying to use his service as much as we can. Okay, so I'll go with my bite-sized pieces, let's say. First, you cut them into strips, put them all on top of each other, and then cut into any size you like. Hajan.
What are you making?
These are lavash chips.
Lavash chips?
Yes. You want some? It's not chips, it's just lavash.
That's it?
That's it, yes.
Not right now, no.
Okay, I'll cut them into diamond shapes. Oh, your Lego fell, Arka.
What?
Your Lego. On the floor, I don't know, probably the money. I lined my baking pan with parchment paper. You don't have to, it doesn't stick, but it's easier to clean. And your next step is to spice and season the bread. I'm used to spicing it by hand and by eyeballing, so but it's a good idea to combine everything in one place. That way everything incorporates evenly. So what I do, I look at my lavash, let's say, or whatever I'm spicing, seasoning, it could be meat, anything. I look at it and I put spices according to my look. I don't know, it may sound weird, but it helps. Okay, so I'll go with my olive oil. And just as I mentioned, everything to taste. And that's it. Nothing dramatic will happen if this or that spice is not as much as you wanted. You can always add more, but you can't go less, yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, salt. I prefer sea salt, or I started liking this pink salt, Himalayan salt. So I'll go with my liked salt. That's it. Quick mix. If you don't want to grab anything, simply with one of your lavash, Use one of your lavashes. Pour the dressing over and nicely, thoroughly rub the bread. Just like so. And of course you will properly scrape everything. Arrange on your baking pan. You can put them close to each other but not on top of each other so they dry out perfectly. Another way to dry them out evenly and perfectly is using either pizza pan or a cooling rack. Simply place it on your baking pan and go from there. But if you overuse oil in this case, it may start dripping, so pay attention. You don't want to overuse it or else you'll end up with nasty or burn oil smell from your oven, and you don't want that. Okay, so let me arrange this very quickly. This will bake about 10 to 15 minutes and I'll turn this upside down halfway baking, through baking. Okay, you are right. Okay, I'll go get another baking pan. I'll do double pan. Did you hear me saying I'll do double pan? I keep inventing new English words. Okay, I'll go grab the other pan. The other one, I'll make it this way and let you know which one dries out better and faster. Okay, ready. And of course, if you're doing the double pan option, remember to switch the pans in between baking. Okay, let me go. And at this weather, I only cook in my garage. This baked about 10 minutes. I didn't even get a chance to turn them upside down. They dried out so perfectly, nicely, golden color, crispy, crunchy. So, so good. And since I already spiced this so well, I have garlic, I have, I was gonna say curry, and curry is a good idea, by the way. It will go so well with these chips. Anyways, since it's already spiced, you don't want to enjoy it with some kind of well-spiced dip like hummus or any other strongly flavored dip. I would suggest to go with simple yogurt, strained yogurt, just the way you like it. If you want to add some garlic to your yogurt or some herbs, anything you prefer. So this was basically it. I'm gonna put my yogurt in here and I wanna nicely arrange my martini cup. When I find my knife, I'll cut the lemon. Okay. And this was it. Simple, easy. I'll put down very quick, detailed instructions on my website at tavine.com. Try it, let me know how you liked it. Thank you so much for watching. Very bad lemon. Apparently this heat damaged my neighbor's lemon tree. All lemons came down from the tree and got damaged. Very, very sad story.
And this guy is very hungry.
This guy is very hungry and I still want to get a lemon. Oh, I'll use a lime. I have good limes.
Nice.
4-3, it's a huge lemon tree.
I got, here's a lemon.
That's not good one. I can already see, I know. Sun damages not only gives you some warmth and coziness, it also damages, especially your skin. Right, Arka?
Right.
Yeah.
But better if you use lime.
But it's better if you use lime. this is a completely unnecessary thing to do, but just in case, to give you an idea, in case you'll be serving this to your guests, you want to make it look nice. So what you do, you simply place your yogurt in your martini cup with some limes down there, and let me show you. Also, some olive oil will give it a nice design, and make a space for olive, just like this. Pour it in there. Oops. And you already know what I'm going to do, right? Of course you know. Halibut. That's it. And it's asking me for some herbs, which I'm gonna do. You wanna make all the things to look perfectly. 1 minute. Done with photo shoot. The best moment is to taste. And by the way, whenever you make something with my recipes, tag me on your Instagram. I really want to see what you made. And thanks to those who already done that. I love seeing my recipes on your Instagram pages. Anyways, let me taste it as if I never tasted it. Delicious. The cold yogurt with this spicy chips goes so perfectly, so good. Try it, let me know how you liked it, and I'm sure you will love it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon. No double dipping.